about the cause of our physical ailments of any kind, which is on a metaphysical level, how to turn that around. We constantly inhale illnesses. How do we inhale that basically? We have those causes, understand, but what are those causes actually? That one is constant produce of negative thoughts, which invoke feelings and makes us emotional. And then they get embedded in our subconscious mind, right? And law of attraction works tirelessly. So it brings back to you all that you put in there. Another thing is being in company of people or around people who are constantly gossiping, cribbing, complaining. They literally throw all their emotional garbage onto you. You know, and we don't know how to help them. We don't know how to remove that. And we can't even throw them out of the window, isn't it? So they tend to do that. They throw all their emotional garbage on us and then we don't know. And then it sort of stays with us. Of course, last time I did tell you that when we visit sick people, they tend to draw on your energy because they're unwell. And naturally, you have a higher energy than them, then they tend to pull that out from you too. And we don't know about that. But it happens. And sometimes you even feel tired because of that when you come back. Rather not most of the time. You know, we are constantly borrowing or absorbing energies from everything around us. Everything. You know, I personally don't wear jewelry of the old people. People who've been lying around the house, like rings and earrings and things like that. Because they have worn it for how long, what energy they have absorbed from the environment of what has happened in that time in history. And then we are wearing that and unknowingly we absorb all that. Whatever things they are, jewelry, clothes, anything. Everything collects energy and personal items generally tend to do that. And then when we use them, or it is still in our environment, even if you don't use them, they tend to throw that energy onto you. At the same time, we ourselves are constantly using our energy for various purposes. So we throw out our energy. We use it up. It depletes us and we don't have a way of getting it back. Right? How do we get back our own energy? Media. It's constantly throwing all that on us, stimulating us, drawing us outwards, telling us what is right for us, wrong for us. Or what is not enough for us, you know. And if we don't follow all that, we don't fit into it. Like it's highly materialistic. And it stops us from traversing inwards, that is going inwards, because it is all outwards. So all that stagnant energy becomes heavy and it weighs us down. We have relationships which have problems. We have jobs that may pay us well, but then it sort of disturbs us day in and day out because we're not happy doing whatever we are doing. You know, there are things lying unused around the house or maybe over a couple of years and they're cluttering, they're taking up the space and the energy has become very stagnant over there. And hoarding, insecurity, hoarding about things like we may later on have it, not have it. Let's get it right now and let's keep it with us. Who knows when we'll need it? Hoarding. All this collects the energy, it makes it stagnant and we are moving around all that. And of course, basic stuff we always know. Inactive lifestyle, not having healthy food, not having proper sleep, you know. All that also definitely further adds to our stagnant energy, right? So now, how to remove all that baggage, lighten our burden, be content with ourselves the way we are. Exhale all the diseases now that we have inhaled all. And let's exhale all that. How does one go about doing this? You know, I'll give you some simple tips or ideas. Like, well, it is a well-known thing, these things are. One is Sai Baba was known to sit under a neem tree, you know that? And not that he needed healing, but all those people who came to visit him, those who are his disciples and those who were not his disciples, rather against him. But anybody who visited him got the healing from the neem tree through his blessings. Another thing, example that we are thinking, how people, in spite of being with negative energy of any kind, how they manage to safeguard themselves. doctors, nurses, and so many other medical personnel, the staff, they're constantly with sick people. But they don't get emotionally attached or involved with their patients. They safeguard with not attaching emotions to any of them. Have you ever noticed that? That's why sometimes we find them impersonal. They talk nicely, they're friendly, they're helpful, but they will not spare any emotion for you. That is their way of self-defense. And then there is one important thing that most people never notice it. You know, those people who collect garbage every single day of every single household. All kinds of garbage they collect first thing in the morning. And you'd be surprised all those stuff that we throw out, how much emotional garbage goes along with that garbage that we throw out on a physical level. But you'd be surprised that they may fall sick because of their own emotional problems, but they don't get fall sick with even in spite of all the garbage they handle every single day. Because again, when they're doing it for them, it's just a job to earn money, right? They don't attach any emotion to that. So that is one way to look at it, that they collect the garbage of every single household first thing in the morning. But they don't attach any kind of emotion to that. Something to think about, isn't it? Doctors, nurses, warriors or garbage collectors, these are the people who generally don't get affected by all this that easily. So now, with all this, sometimes you really want to go out and scream, you know, shout out. It is okay to do that. Go into the room, close everything, scream and shout. If you want to cry, you can cry your heart out. Fine, all that is done. Then now what? You still have to come out and face your life, isn't it? So how do you go about that? Where to begin? Before we eliminate the unwanted energy. See, it is, we always trying to remove all that is negative, but it is not easy to just do that in one go. So before we eliminate the unwanted energy and create a void, that could get unfavorable. Because the moment you remove something, then there is a void. Now, if that void is not filled up rightly, you may have another added problem, you know, because there are a lot of things beyond the physical realm which we are not aware of, the elementals and all, and they get caught on. So we must gather and strengthen our energy level, which will slowly and steadily start replacing that energy which is unwanted in a very beautiful way, and then you can go further ahead. Secondly, with the potency of our energy, we can start transforming our metaphysical foundation then, which will assist, of course, in developing our nature too. So simple little things, you'd be surprised how they help, because I've been reading and reading about it. Just best when you're doing some work and you just whistle your way, or you have just jump a little, you know, you sing, you dance while cooking, you sing, you hear music. Somebody tickles you, you tickle somebody. You know, these little things day to day when you do, you're enjoying your life, you're enjoying the work you're doing, and it starts replacing the stagnant energy that you have inside of you. Important thing is like that you're enjoying that. Laugh throughout the day. Find funny things to do, find funny things to say, to hear, to share with somebody, you know. Have laughter as an absolute daily dose of your life. Moment you start, it is really true that laughter is the best medicine. And of course, our creative side, most of us over the years, we tend to let it go, like singing, dancing, drawing, painting, cooking, writing, reading, gardening, and it goes on and on and on. But you must bring out, it doesn't have to be perfect, it does not have to be for anybody else, it's just for yourself that you enjoy doing it. Because the anything that you have as a creative ability within you, it is actually helping you to spiritually grow. And why? Because it is actually a spiritual muscle that you're supposed to use through your creativity, which we don't know about. Actually, all the talents, skills, and abilities that we have are meant to actually help you grow spiritually. They make you use your spiritual muscle. And how is that? Moment you love to do something, no matter what happens, you will see that somehow you get that done, isn't it? If it's any hurdles, any blocks, any problems, anything they come in your way, you see that you're working on it. So it's somebody or someone or something. That means you're using your spiritual muscle to overcome all those hurdles, all those negativity, all those people who come in your way. So the creative part of you always makes you really strengthen your spiritual muscle to take people as they are, leave them if it is negative, not get into that because you're so focused on what you want to do. Nothing else bothers you. You don't have time to gossip or complain or grumble because you're busy doing something that you really wish to achieve. Isn't it? So creativity is one important art. That's why you see all these dancers and singers, they somehow tend to be spiritually inclined somewhere along, isn't it? Because they're busy focusing on their talent so much that they're one with that. And you have no time for anything else then. So within you, whatever you have, work on that. Salt is a centuries old ingredient used for cleansing on all levels. Ill people and old people are generally given lukewarm salt water sponge baths that help both in cleansing their bodies and keep illnesses at bay. Fruits and vegetables soaked in salt water remove all germs and viruses. Handful of salt while swapping the floor keeps most of your insects and flies and mosquitoes at bay. And all those people who are now on the spiritual path, pranic healers and Reiki and so many others, they generally use salt to do the aura cleansing of as a healer, you know. Affirmations. Most important about affirmations. To remain positive, we have to first speak positively to ourselves. When we lack in something, we'll end up praying for it fervently, expecting it to happen sometime in future, not having faith for it to happen in the present. If we have to improve on our habits, we vow to be better henceforth by affirming that we shall not continue with that bad habit anymore. When we show concern for anyone, we display with words that quoted danger first, rather than affection, creating fear in the other person. It means what? Even our affirmations have negative words in that. Instead of saying, God, please bless me with financial prosperity, we can say, God, thank you for blessing me with financial security or opportunities for financial prosperity. I shall not have soft drinks anymore. Instead of saying that, I shall consume healthy food drinks. Do not cross the road or you may face an accident. Instead, we can say, check the traffic more so in absence of signals, then cross the road safely. So whatever, whenever we are talking, we have to take care that we first don't use negative words ourselves for anything. Then you strengthen your affirmations in that particular way and then can use those affirmations. Affirmations are available galore on the Google. You can create your own in any way that you want. And be with nature, walk in nature. Forgiveness is the biggest tool that you have actually. It is forgiveness and mercy is above the law of karma. Once there is a realization, forgiveness is the first and best tool towards healing ourselves and lessening the impact of our karma. We have to learn to forgive ourselves first and also others. And the word ho'oponopono. So use those, you know, simple things. It is my personal and I tell you. My dearest darling, so and so, it may be a person, place, thing, event, experience, dream, anything, anyone past, present, or even upcoming near future. I am sorry, please forgive me. I forgive you. I love you. I thank you. With deep gratitude, great respect, and immense love, I hereby set you all free on all levels. Be in peace. Be peace. Go in peace, into the divine light, be the divine light. It has helped me over the years tremendously. You know, so, and gratitude, be in gratitude. You have so much already with you. Every drop of water that you drink, every morsel of food you have, the clothes you wear, the house you live in, the family, the friends, whatever. There's so many, the comforts that we enjoy, the house help we get, people around us doing so many little things for us. Why do we focus on what we don't have and focus on what we already are having it and enjoying it on a day-to-day basis? So gratitude is very, very, very important for all this. The healing can never happen until the time you don't have forgiveness and gratitude within you. So let's begin. Sit comfortably. You can close your eyes. Relax your body. Feel your whole body relaxing. From your feet to your knees, to your hips, the thighs, your stomach, your whole abdomen, the chest, the back, the lower back, the middle back, the higher back, your shoulders, your fingers and palms, your wrist, your hands, forearms, elbows, forearms, shoulders, your neck, front and back, your back head, your jaw, your ears, nose, eyes, forehead, your head. Relax completely. Whatever the sounds you hear, let them be. Don't focus on them, but just acknowledge them. Feel the light breeze on your body. Focus on your breathing now. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, your stomach fills up like a balloon. Exhale, your stomach caves in. Inhale, hold. Exhale, hold. Inhale, hold. Exhale, hold. Inhale, hold. Focus on your breathing. Now imagine there's a wide, bright light in the sky directly shining upon you. It's like you're in the spotlight of the skylight. Suddenly there's one more light green color, beautiful, soft, soothing, cleansing, healing, refreshing, fertile, beautiful, nurturing green light coming down onto you. All over you, it's you're absorbing that green light through your head, brain, eyes, nose, jaw, ears, neck, shoulders, your full hand, your chest, your stomach, full abdomen, your upper back, lower back, middle back, lower back. Feel that the green light is coming down through your spine like water through the tap, right from top, from your middle of your head to the bottom of the spine. It's still flowing through your hips, to your legs, full legs till the toes. Cleansing you, healing you, like all the unfresh, unclean, unhealthy, dirty, negative, impure energies are all extracted, disintegrated and expelled rapidly, safely, properly, completely, absolutely, right here, right now, from your entire body. Disintegrated completely. Imagine a cord from the bottom of your spine going to the middle of the earth, center of the earth. Feel all that gray matter from your entire body being sucked out through that cord into the core of the earth. Thank Mother Earth for absorbing all the negative energy as a sacrifice and releasing you from all that is unfresh or diseased and blessing you with His divine, nurturing, nourishing energy. Now imagine an electric violet light streaming down completely onto you. Think that you're transparent and you're filled with this light completely. It is absorbing all your negativities from your every thought, every feeling, every emotion, from every chakra to all the layers of your body completely. It's completely absorbing it. It's completely vanishing it. You feel light. You feel one with the light. You feel as though you're floating. You feel cleansed, healed, purified, energized with this divine electric violet light. Feel the presence of the light. Be grateful for this electric violet light to bless you with this divine energies and to elevate your spiritual progress. Bring back your attention to your body. Feel your toes and fingers moving. Slowly and steadily bring your awareness back to your body. With a grateful prayer of absorbing all the divine energies of the green ray and of the electric violet ray into yourself. Bring your palms up to your chest level, facing outwards. Imagine all your loved ones, bless them. All that extra energy can be used to bless them. Visualize Mother Earth in front of you. Bless her with a rejuvenation and all the living beings on this earth. Thank you. And now you can open your eyes.